Let me just nail this down into the coffin, guys. We now know, we've known for ages, that Ichigo has always been restricted, not only by his hollow self and the Shinigami Soul Reaper badge and Zangetsu himself, but now that restriction has been lifted, plus the Squad Zero training, even Ichigo is scared of his own unrestricted fucking Getsuga Tensho. I honestly think he used that move just to say, look, there's my power. Do you still want to fuck with me? And yet this bitch was naive enough to want to go in head on, and Ichigo's like, what the fuck are you doing, you stupid slut? Move out the fucking way. So damn, like, guys, this isn't just some normal Getsuga, like everyone says, oh, Ichigo's using Getsuga Tensho again. This is it, you know, full power, full fucking power Getsuga. And this is like, what, Shikai form? Regardless of the what, the power scale is so immense right now, something we haven't seen before. And through something, through like a little swing of the sword and a little cross, like not even, you know, something he put that much effort in did that much damage to Candice. Like, but guys, Bleach chapter 584, this chapter was fucking awesome. Not only did he fuck up Candice, we got an 8 versus fucking 1. That is fucking awesome. I really, please Kubo, don't play with my fucking balls right now. Make this happen. Make this fucking fight happen. And then Jua Bach. Throughout this whole chapter, this dude is mind fucking me. Like, I'm so confused that the light to what? The key to what? Why would you need a key to bring all of your stone rivers back into you to make you one again? That's what I'm saying. Anyway, I would say, okay, he's using a technique that, you know, brings all the stone writers to him once more, making them one being. But then there was a key mentioned and a pillar of light. So I'm thinking they're making their own way to Squad Zero or the Spirit King. Possibly. I mean, shit, what the fuck do I know? As I said, this dude mind fucked me. Like, I have no idea. So I'm really fucking hyped to see what this motherfucker's up to. I hope he doesn't absorb all the stone writers, because I want to see it's 8 versus one fight. But we've also got confirmation about Bambietta. Bambietta is not a fucking zombie. She is alive. She's got to be alive. Unless they killed her, which that would be really fucked. But I doubt they killed her, to be quite honest with you. I reckon she is healed. It's still like a mystery, but how Gigi said, you know, I can't turn a Quincy, specifically Quincy, into a zombie unless they are dead. But she can heal with or without blood, I guess, because Candice specifically says, don't use any blood. Something along them lines. And then Basby coming in like a fucking badass, one finger blasting, finger blasting all these girls. Yes, that is very sexual the way I just said that. Finger blasting with one finger. All these girls, Candice, Gigi, fucking big titty bitch, and fucking little lowly gluttony bitch, and they went down like a bag of shit. Now, I'm guessing Basby wanted to take Ichigo all by himself, but then three other the Stone Rooters came along, which I was like, oh shit, and they said, okay, let's divide this equally, and then the Stone Rooter girls got back up and said, no, it's whoever gets his head first claims the prize. And I'm like, oh shit, is this going down? Is this really going down? An 8 versus 1 with Ichigo? Ah! The fanboy, like, my penis rose so hard. Like, am I about to see this? No, of course, I gotta wait till next week if that happens, but still. Just a fucking hype chapter. I was expecting more of a clarification explanation about Ichigo's new technique, but instead we got some really good hype, like really good fucking hype. And if you didn't notice, Basby was also, and I guess in bowl standing like form, because he had like the little Quincy crown and the little wings, just saying. But yeah, we did learn quite a few stuff in this chapter, such as where Bambietta might be and the zombie girl Gigi's power. Ichigo is OP as fuck that he's even scared of his own Getsugas. Jua Bach is being mindfuckery. Stop being eyes on Jua Bach. You can't fucking do it. Uryu looks shook. I'm basically just about to see some good ass fucking fights go down. I'm really fucking hyped. And I'm not talking as a reviewer. I'm talking as a fucking fan, because holy shit. Please, this is where Bleach needs to like just jump in their rankings now. This is the point where Kubo's like, fuck it. Let's go. Fucking 8 versus one. Come at him, bro. So yeah, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below. Here's the comment from last week. Candice Catnip, like, she's a bitch, but we know, and she acts like we know what she is. She's like exactly what it says on the tin. This is a crazy bitch. She's definitely a bitch. Everybody knows she's a bitch. And she does a good job of being a bitch. And she's hot. Very hot. But definitely like a crazy bitch. Like she's like, man, fuck this motherfucker. I'm gonna go in. I don't care. And then like her people are telling her, stop being a bitch. They ain't gonna get you nowhere. But anyway, before I carry on with this fucking candy shit, I'll catch you motherfuckers later. I'm really hyped for the next Bleach chapter. Let's fucking go. And you guys, of course, have been Hanson, so I'll catch you guys later, motherfuckers. Peace.